What is a comorbidity?
Comorbidity is a chronic disease that is not myeloma, that you have besides your myeloma, you can say that. It could be chronic pulmonary lung disease, it can be congestive heart failure or diabetes and other cancers as well.
What comorbidities are most prevalent in newly diagnosed myeloma?
I can tell you a little bit about what it is in Denmark, because I think that comorbidities varies from culture to culture. What we do have, and we did a study again on the Danish quality database where we looked at newly diagnosed myeloma patients and comorbidity. And what was interesting was that 1 year preceding the diagnosis, there was an increase in comorbidities. And there is comorbidities like kidney failure, which is part of the myeloma disease, but also congestive heart failures, chronic pulmonary lung diseases, diabetes was there. And in total, 40% of the patients had comorbidities at diagnosis. So that's a lot of patients with comorbidities as early in their myeloma history, because it also develops throughout their history due to treatment.
How do comorbidities impact treatment decisions?
You will have worse outcome, and we presented that. The hazard ratio was about 2, I think, in overall survival, which is quite a lot.
Is treatment modified when dealing with comorbidities?
You do modify treatment because you don't choose a drug that will give you neuropathy if you have neuropathy. And if you, for example, also have had a previous pulmonary embolism, then you're reluctant with the IMiDs. It can be done, but you have to be very careful. And I think that today, where you have so many treatment options, I mean, the patients do better. Patients that have comorbidities, for example, chronic pulmonary diseases and heart diseases that are severe, they cannot go through a transplant. A transplant is still the first option for younger patients in Scandinavia. I know it's changing in US, but it's still what we do here. And then you have to treat them otherwise with the standard treatments that are available for us and modifying the treatment. If you are so unlucky that you have comorbidity that will disqualify you from the best treatment, I think that even in countries where there are restrictions to treatment, then you should really work very hard for giving the absolute best treatment you can for the patients, even though it may not be approved at diagnosis, simply because the life expectancy of this patient could be shorter. And we know that you should use the best thing you can at diagnosis if you want a long life.